notice it. Mount of Mayhem is only days away.
No.
And we're waiting for you to dive in and find your first Nautilus.
Wow!
So with Mounts of Mayhem, we were really looking to see what we could do with mounted combat, and we were focusing on the horses a lot. But then we realized there was an area where we don't really have any mounts at all, and that's the water.
It's a little goofy when you kind of look at it in like third person, but I think it's fun in its own way.
Oh, kind of like
yeah.
That.
Yeah.
So we balanced the Nautilus in the game progression around where you can first get to the pufferfish.
There we go, some pufferfish.
We associate the pufferfish with the water breathing potion, so the ability to be underwater, and it's the tool used for taming the Nautilus. Because we expect players to find the Nautilus quite early on, we need it to not override everything else we have in the underwater ecosystem. For this reason, there's a challenge. The oxygen is paused when you're riding the Nautilus. This means you have a limited amount of time to dismount and do your underwater activity before you're forced to come back to the Nautilus.
And like some places are too small for the Nautilus to fit in, like shipwrecks.
Very unfortunate, I'll have to go back up. Where is my Nautilus? Oh God! Where did the Nautilus go?
So there's a little bit of tension as you have to leave it behind while you're exploring.
We can see the bubble effect that is going faster the faster you go with the Nautilus. If you dash, you can see the bubbles going even faster.
We knew we were going to be adding an underwater mount, and we had the spear in development. So adding the dash to the Nautilus, it was a match made in heaven. It just made the perfect combat situation underwater.
Whee! There was one moment when the dash force was so strong that you got launched up in the air, and that was not something we decided should go out.
We've already had the Nautilus item in game, so this was kind of a way to also kind of tie back into that. I had to make sure that the stripes were nice and vibrant, because with this mob being underwater, the blue hue would like really tone down some of these oranges. It's always interesting trying to translate something that's so curvilinear and very like circular into like more of like a cube kind of shape. But I think it was a lot of fun to work on. So for the zombie version, we kind of went the opposite direction, where instead of this nice bright orange hue, you have these kind of like deep, like dark kind of greens, and then you have the drowned eyes, which on vibrant visuals are like nice and glowy and everything.
I think the biggest thing for me is just like how sinister it looks.
Especially with a drone on top of it, because then you have two pearl eyes shining.
You don't want to see that.
Admittedly, I was inspired by escargot, because you see the shells and like the little herbs and stuff that are kind of on there. But yeah, you can't eat them. I liked the idea of possibly having coral on the zombie Nautilus and having it look like overgrown and everything. But we wanted the zombie Nautilus to spawn in different biomes, so it didn't really make sense for it to have coral. But we were really fond of the coral version, so we went through and got that added in. But you can only find it in the warm oceans.
The thing with the zombie coral Nautilus is it's going to be very rare, so you're going to need to work hard to try and spot this one. When players get their hands on the Nautilus, we expect that they'll be jumping underwater a lot more earlier in the game. And with that, I'm going to predict that we're going to see more underwater builds. We're going to see more incredible structures.
More jousting. Everyone needs more jousting.
One of my favorite things I saw a player do when this was in testing is they took the Nautilus on the land and they made that their challenge. How quickly can I get the Nautilus back into the ocean?
Mounts of Mayhem is only a few days away, and we are very excited to see what you all will come up with.
So you better start collecting those pufferfishes.